Good morning. Sorry for our inconvenience because Professor Paschaloudis does not feel so good, so cannot make the presentation, and I'm going to make his presentation. Our paper is about green hotels and Generation Y in Greece. First of all, let me give definition what are green hotels according to Green Hotel Association. Green hotels are environmentally friendly properties whose managers are eager to institute programs that save water, save energy, and reduce solid waste while saving money in order to help to protect our one and only Earth. Going green is an attractive trend for companies, so they go green for many reasons, more than the protection of the environment, like legitimation, facing public scrutiny, improved public image, increased brand value, lowering operating costs, generating profit, strengthening employee organization commitment, and of course pleasing the customer. Thus, one important reason for hotels to go green is the customer. Up to now, guest environmental awareness and concerns rapidly increased after 1999. Thus, nowadays, consumers understand that their purchasing decisions influence the environment. So, we can claim that it is important for them to choose a hotel that integrates the principles of sustainable development and contributes to the preservation of the environment. So I'm going now to give a definition about Generation Y. Generation Y are people that were born between the 80s and 2000. They are also called millennials. Previous studies have proved that Generation Ys are civic-minded and social conscious individuals and consumers. They want quality goods. They are also brand loyal, and they are also willing to pay more for brand names. A study conducted by Marriage Poll on 2007 proved that the majority, 77% of the responders claimed that they care about the environment. So, I'm coming to the aim of our study. Consumers, the study aims at investigating consumers' perceptions about green hotel and their intentions to choose a green hotel. More specifically, it examines environmental concerns, eco-friendly activities, eco-friendly attitudes, awareness, the overall image, intention to pay more, and intention to visit a Greek hotel. And as I mentioned previously, it takes only into consideration generation wise wide perceptions and attitudes. So we conducted an empirical study using an online survey. We used Facebook in order to promote the study to users. And we have put links to to many profiles of Facebook users, of the researchers, and many more. This notified the users for the online questionnaire. And users that were willing to participate in the study, they visited a tailor-made questionnaire, a website, and then they responded to the questionnaire. One of the characteristics that were recorded was year of birth, because we want only Generation Y attitude. So from all the questionnaires that were received, we used only those that the responders' age bracket is from 80 to 2000. So we have finally 159 completed and usable questionnaires that used for the study. The questionnaire consists of seven parts that they are for the seven constructs used. The questions were adopted or adapted from previous for the constructs were adapted or adopted for from previous studies, and we used several point Likert scales that range from strongly disagree to strongly agree, and from very negative to very positive. First of all, we checked it, the reliability and the internal consistency of the constructs. We used the compact alpha coefficients, as we can see here. The values of all alphas are sufficiently high, as all of them are over 0.7. Regarding environmental concerns, we can claim that participants are highly environmentally conscious, as the mean values of the questions that investigate environmental concerns are very high, from 5.71 to 6.49. The bigger score was the higher score was recorded the questions humans must live in harmony with the nature in order to survive. That we can say that the responders seem that they have a holistic worldview of where all the living, all the creatures are vitally connected, and the natural environment should be in balance in order to survive. Next, we investigated eco-friendly activities and eco-friendly attitudes. We can claim that participants have positive attitudes. They strongly believe that recycling will reduce pollution. Here we have a mean of 6.9, and that it is important to save natural resources. We have a mean of 6.30. And we can claim that their eco-friendly activities seem that they are aligned with their attitudes. As we have, as they claim that recycling is not too much trouble for them, and they can also keep a separate piles of garbage for recycling. These questions means of 2.7 and 2.58. These questions were reverse coded. Here is we can see the histogram of awareness. Participants, although they have high environmental concerns, they seem that they are not aware about Green Hotel. The mean value, the average is 3.76, and as we can see here, the answers have high variability. So, generation Y, we can claim that it is a savvy generation who knows what they want, and if not, they can Google it and rapidly find it using technology. So, in this file, we can say that Green Hotel marketers should communicate their campaigns more and to their potential customers, and emphasize on the importance of various environmental issues. So for the green hotels, new technology and social media can provide a compelling channel in order to communicate campaigns to Generation Y consumers. Then, we recorded willingness to pay more and intention to visit a Green Hotel. Willingness to pay more has essentially lower average, 3.85, than the intention to visit a Green Hotel, which is the average is 5.13. This empirical finding was verified by paired sample t-tests, where the p-value is sufficiently low. So we can claim that generation Y customers are not willing to pay more. So in order to enhance generation Y's intention to visit a hotel property, hotel managers should pay more attention to find and use ways to increase first positive attitudes, and then to keep their prices low, as in at least at equal to those of conventional hotels. So, I'm coming to the conclusions. The primary aim of the paper was to examine factors that involve in eco-friendly decision-making processes and intention to choose a green hotel. In order to enable further understanding with this green debate, we take a generational approach, and we investigated attitudes of Generation Y. Although this generation consumers claim, and it was proven from previous studies, that they are highly environmentally conscious, we found that a clear gap exists in awareness about green hotels. As young consumers are becoming more and more aware of environmental issues, the hotel industry should not only adopt green practices, but also to communicate them and create awareness and educate consumers for conservation of their senses. The young consumers are not willing to pay more for environmental friendly practices, despite that they have a positive attitude and disposition towards the environment. We can tell that hotel industry should adapt pricing policies to customer needs and wants, and keep the prices of green hotels at the same level with the conventional hotels. So regarding the study, it has some limitations. At the future, we are going to take a structural equation modeling approach in order to investigate the relationship regarding the proposed constructs, the six proposed constructs, and the intention to visit the Greek hotel. Thank you.
I am from Yıldız Technical University, Istanbul. Feride Gönel, my name is. I have two questions. Yes. Do you have any information about that makes a comparison with other generations from the literature or maybe from your empirical research?
Because no, we take only into consideration only this generation. Because they are, can use technology. They are technical savvy, so they can, and only this, just only this.
And did you find any unexpected result from your?
Yes, we found an unexpected result regarding their willingness to pay more. Previous studies have found that Generation Y pays more for products that they come from brand who have known brand names. So this is not very.
Okay, thank you.
So they're not willing to pay for green services, but they are willing to pay more for brands. Is that correct? So the thing is, the young people are willing to pay more for brands.
Yes, but not for green policies.
So this solution seems to be is how do you make green into a brand? So if you can make green
yes.
into a brand, how might you do that?
I think that hotels can promote their green policies and more than they do for the moment, so they can connect their brand names with green policies.
Just on that issue then, but if a brand has to become quite big, a small hotel, you know, it's very difficult for it to...
Yes, for small hotels,
so,
you are right.
So in a way, you know, if you had a big if they all were part of some league where they all had the same brand, it sort of seems to be...
Yes, there exists an association. It is the Green Hotel Association, so they can use this name in order to promote their practices.
I think to add to this discussion is that it has been happening a lot through the marketing field, and marketers and organizations are very wise nowadays, and in order to market their brands, they're using celebrities. And the Generation Y tend to gravitate towards celebrities. And this is why some of the celebrities, when they fall and do any mistakes, they are slaughtered, because all those generations are running after them and imitating them. So they have to be role models. So the wise ones are taking good celebrities with good names and making them their advocates and using them in marketing. And it's already being happening in this green field, I mean, worldwide, and you see it on the TV every day. So I think some of them started using that technique in marketing.
Thank you.
Question, please.
I think the way the hotels are moving ahead is by theme.
It's by
theme. So they have a theme.
Yes.
And the green could be the theme that meets with the brand name. So when you go to a hotel room, it's all green, and you've got environmental themes, and the pool is green. And so I think that if you use the theme and bring that into the brand name, and this is one way maybe you can bring in the concept of green into the brand name. I was wondering whether you looked at these theme hotels. So there's a hotel 1970s, for instance. So you go in, all the 70s actors, pictures. So they have a theme. I was wondering whether this could be incorporated into the green as a theme to a hotel, so that you combine branding and the payment for
it.
It could be of interest into the
interview.
Thank you.
Thank you.